Good morning. Forgot to close my door. hold on a second while I get us going live on Facebook. So happy Mother's Day to everybody out there. There we go. For some reason, it wasn't allowing me to click and go live on Facebook. So we will just make our way through whatever challenges come, knowing that it will all be well. So here we go. So we are live on Facebook and admitting everybody into the room this morning. So, everybody, welcome, welcome. Super. All right. Awesome. I think everyone is connected and we are live in Facebook. So we're able to get going. And for all of you moms out there, happy Mother's Day. So today is day 12. We're already more than a third of the way through. It's beautiful to be journeying and continuing to journey with all of you. Oh, thank you so much. Both Sharon and Happy Mother's Day, Happy Mother's Day, Happy Mother's Day. Good morning, all. So beautiful, gentle way to start our day with our mother, Mary. So let's begin with asking the Holy Spirit to come and be with us. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, amen. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of thy faithful and enkindle in them the fire of thy love. Send forth thy spirit and they shall be created, and thou shalt renew the face of the earth. O God, who didst teach the hearts of thy faithful people by sending them the light of thy Holy Spirit, grant us by the same Spirit to have right judgment in all things and evermore to rejoice in his holy comfort through Christ our Lord. Amen. O Holy Spirit, sweet guest of my soul, abide in me and grant that I may ever abide in thee. So, our reflection for today. A young branch can easily be bent to the desired direction of the gardener. However, if a branch is allowed to grow unattended, it may wander in the wrong direction. If the branch remains without correction for a long time, it requires great force to move it. Likewise, if a tree has been allowed to grow in the wrong direction for considerable time, it may need to be cut to its trunk and then allowed to grow anew. This correction is much more painful. Our soul is like a tender branch, and it is therefore of great benefit to be guided by Our Lady from a tender age. In this way, Our Lady can make the corrections gently. So, our goal today, while children are tender and young, they easily can be brought in the direction of holiness, where they can become sturdy in faith and love. I can attest to this in my own life, and I'm sure everyone can remember a time when you began practicing a habit early on in your life, and it was much easier to continue with that habit as you got older versus forming not so good habits and then having to try and change them later. Case in point being eating habits, when you get used to eating things that aren't necessarily good for you, and then you try to, switch your taste buds, develop and cultivate a taste for something new, it's much more difficult. And so that's just one instance. But in our spiritual life, if we don't cultivate that habit of daily prayer, it becomes harder and harder to do the later on that we try to begin that practice. But that doesn't mean that it's not possible. It just means it's a little bit more painful because we're having to set our mindset. We're having to change how it is that we're approaching each of our days. We're having to, become and put God first versus ourselves first, which we tend to do when we get up in the morning and we might be a little cranky or, want to do our comfortable things that we always do. And it's about us figuring out how can we be pruned, how can we be put in the proper direction without quite as much pain. Sometimes it's just downright painful. And we have to realize that there's consequences to all of our actions. If for many, many years we haven't been exercising, and then we try to install an exercise program into our lives, it tends to be a lot more challenging than if this was just the normal thing that we did. We got up every morning and we went for a walk, or we went and did, went for a bike ride, or did something else that was active during our day. And it was just a natural part of how we were. So one of the things that we need to remember is that Our Lady will always guide us, particularly in those habits, in forming those habits that will help us be able to grow closer to Jesus. So whether our soul is a young, tender branch, or whether or not we are a little bit older and even our trunk, it's still possible to be made anew if we allow Our Lady to guide us and shape us. So whatever it is that we're struggling with in our lives, allow Our Lady to help prune us in whatever way, to guide us and to direct us, and be consoled that Our Lady is always the attentive mother that we all long for, and she will be with us throughout. And so it's a very appropriate day that we reflect on this, in which it is Mother's Day throughout the world. So in this same way, let us go ahead and pray our Decade of the Rosary, asking our mother to help us always be mindful of the fact that we all, even if we're not tender and young, we all can be brought in the direction of holiness, and we can become sturdy in faith and love. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. So tomorrow will be day 13. We'll continue on our journey. For those of you who've jumped on to Facebook and also here on Zoom, if you have any questions or comments or anything that you would like to share, please do so at this time. Otherwise, I'll see most of you again tomorrow. So.